The multiple copy tool is an efficiency feature to quickly create and easily space numerous copies of an object or a group of objects. In this video, we will look at how to use multiple copy tool and its two editing behaviors. A bit later in the video, we will look at some other uses for the tool. Here I am in a plan, and I've already placed one recessed can light towards the bottom right-hand corner. To use the multiple copy tool, select the desired object, and in the bottom toolbar, select the multiple copy tool. Next, you can select the multiple copy interval button to tell the program how the copying behavior should behave. The multiple copy tool has two editing behaviors. The first editing behavior, which is this top section, says offset between copies when dragging. When this option is selected, when you drag your mouse across the screen, the program will place a copy of the object you have selected the specified offset distance apart. You will notice that there are options for general objects, trusses, rafters, joist posts, beams, and wall studs. The can light I have selected falls under the general objects category, but if you had selected any of these type of objects, they would have fallen under the applicable category. There's also this option that says rotation of all objects. We will look at this later on in the video. Let's start by looking at the primary offset. The primary offset is the first direction you move your mouse across the screen. My current primary offset is set to 72 inches or 6 feet, meaning I'll place a copy of this can light every 72 inches as I move my mouse across the screen. So with the 72 inch offset specified, I'm going to click on OK. And now watch what happens to my mouse cursor as I bring it over the object. The mouse cursor icon changes, indicating I've activated the multiple copy tool. And if I click and hold my left mouse button, the key here being you have to hold that left click, and drag my mouse across the screen, we will place a copy of the can light every 72 inches until I release my mouse. As I'm dragging my mouse, notice that the copies are highlighted. The objects are not placed in the plan until you release the left mouse button, so if you made a mistake and realize you do not want to place these copies, you can press spacebar on your keyboard, which will cancel the edit and release the multiple copy tool. In this case, I'm happy with the placement of the copies, so I am going to release my mouse button, and the copies will be placed in the plan. We can confirm that the can lights are 72 inches or 6 feet apart by using the center line dimension tool and drawing a dimension line through those can lines. Let's press undo a few times and take a look at using both a primary and a secondary offset. I'm back to having a single can light in the plan. If I select the can light and then select the multiple copy edit button, and then select the multiple copy interval button. In addition to setting a primary offset, we can set a secondary offset, which allows us to drag copies of all the objects we placed in the primary offset into a secondary offset or direction. Let's specify the secondary offset to be 84 inches or 7 feet. So to review, we will place copies of the can light every 72 inches in our primary offset, and then copies of all those objects every 84 inches in our secondary offset. Let's click on OK. And I'm going to bring my mouse over the object. And this time, instead of left clicking, I'm going to click and hold my right mouse button in order to use both a primary and secondary offset. To review, clicking and holding the left mouse button will only activate the primary offset, but if you click and hold with the right mouse button, it will activate both the primary and secondary offset. With my right mouse button being held, I'm going to drag out copies every 72 inches in our primary offset. And once I release my right mouse button, not clicking yet, and move my mouse in a new direction, I will be placing copies every 84 inches in the secondary offset. Once I am ready to place the copies, I can click with my left or right mouse button, or to cancel, press spacebar on the keyboard. I'm going to click to paste the copies, and we can confirm that these copies have been placed every 72 and 84 inches apart by going up to our dimension tools, selecting the centerline dimension tool, and clicking and dragging a dimension line through these lights. Let's press undo a few times to get back to having a single can light. Now that we know how the first multiple copy editing behavior works, let's focus on the second multiple copy editing behavior, which allows you to evenly distribute a specified number of copies of an object an equal distance from each other. I'm going to select the can light and select the multiple copy edit button and select the multiple copy interval button. Down here there is an option that says evenly distribute copies when dragging. Here you can specify the number of copies of an object you would like to place, and as you drag your mouse, Chief will place the copies an equal distance from each other. Just like with our other editing behavior, you can set both a primary and secondary number of copies. So I'm going to specify that I want 4 copies in my primary direction and then 5 copies in my secondary direction, and then click on OK. Then with my right mouse button, I'm going to click and hold and drag out 4 copies in my primary direction, and as I drag my mouse out, notice that the distance between the copies increases. And once I'm satisfied with the placement of those 4 copies, I'm going to release my mouse and move my mouse in the secondary direction, placing those 5 secondary copies. And if you're satisfied with the location of these copies, you can click once to place them. Next, let's talk about that option mentioned earlier that says rotation of all objects. Off to the side, I've drawn an 18-inch CAD line, and with that CAD line selected, I'm going to select the multiple copy edit button, and then select the multiple copy interval button, and then select the option at the top that says offset between copies when dragging. Here there's an option that says rotation of all objects. What this means is that by selecting the triangle rotate handle and moving it around the object, we will place copies of the object around the selected object centered in the specified degree increments. The key here is that the rotation is about the selected object center, so if I had 2 objects selected, it would be around the center of those 2 objects. Let's specify the rotation of all objects to be in 30 degree increments. You can specify a secondary offset, which will create copies of the object on center from each other the specified distance. Let's specify the secondary offset to be 36 inches. So to review, I'm going to right-click and hold the triangle edit handle and rotate my mouse, and we will create copies of the CAD line in 30 degree increments. And once I release my mouse, we will then create copies of the CAD line every 36 inches from each other. Let's press on OK and come over to the rotation handle. And notice my mouse icon changes there. And right-click and hold and rotate. And there we are creating the copies in 30 degree increments. And when I release my right click and drag it out, we will create copies of this CAD line every 36 inches from each other. We can confirm that they are every 30 degrees by using the angular dimension tool, and then just measuring the angle between these two lines. And then by using the end-to-end dimension tool, we can confirm that these are 36 inches on center from each other. Let's look at another interesting way to use the multiple copy tool that allows you to place copies of an object around a temporary point in the plan. I am back in the plan, and the first thing I want to do is place a temporary point in the middle of the room. To do this, I'm going to draw 2 CAD lines, one coming from the center of the wall at the bottom, and the other coming from the center of the wall on the right-hand side, and where these 2 lines intersect will be the room center. So to do this, I'm going to go up to my CAD tools, and I'm going to make sure I have the draw line tool selected, and then I'm going to come to this wall on the bottom, and when my mouse is over the center of the wall, I'll get a red triangle indicator indicating that I'm on the center of the wall, and then I'm just going to click and drag a CAD line up into the room, and then I'm going to do the same thing with the wall on the right hand side, and now I know where these 2 lines intersect is my room center. Next, I'm going to come up to my CAD point tools, and I'm going to select the option for place point, and then just come over to where these 2 lines intersect and click once to place a point. The next thing I want to do is place a can light a little bit above our temporary point. So I'm going to go up to our electrical tools and I'm going to select the light option. And then I'm going to come over to this CAD line and just click once to place a can light. And then I'm going to press spacebar and then select these CAD lines and delete them. Next, what I want to do is create copies of this can light evenly spaced around the temporary point. The first step in doing this is to change the program's editing behavior. If I go up to Edit and then down to Edit Behaviors, there's an option here that says Rotate Resize About Current Point. With this edit behavior selected, when I select the can light and use the multiple copy tool, we'll be placing the copies around the temporary point. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the can light and I'm going to select the multiple copy tool. And then I'm going to select the multiple copy interval button. And I'm just going to confirm that the settings are how I want them. I'm going to specify that I'm going to place copies every 30 degrees as I bring my mouse around the temporary point. And then I'm also going to specify my secondary offset to be 60 inches. Alternatively, you could have specified this option evenly distribute copies when dragging, and you would have created a set number of copies evenly spaced around this CAD point. But I'm going to accept these settings and click on OK. And then I'm going to come over to the triangle rotate handle and right click to use both a primary and secondary offset. And I'm going to be creating copies of these can lights every 30 degrees around our temporary point. And I'm going to release my mouse and pull it out, which will create copies in our secondary offset every 60 inches from our original objects. And once you are happy with the placement of the objects, you can click once to place them. The next things you'll want to do are revert back to your original editing behavior. You can do this by going to Edit, and then down to Edit Behaviors, and then just unchecking Rotate Resize About Current Point. And then you'll want to delete this temporary CAD point. You can do this by going to your CAD Point Tools, and then selecting the option that says Delete Temporary Points.